Why did you choose this job then?
I felt that this would give me a sense of real fulfillment of the values that I hold dear, the values of social justice and internationalism that took me into domestic politics in the first place. I felt that there was a soap opera attached with what I... Every time I said anything, what did Ed think about it became a soap opera in British politics. And I'm someone who...
So you felt like you had to leave Britain?
Yes. And I wanted to do something that could really make a difference around the world. I wasn't looking for a big stage, but I wanted to do big things. And the NGO sector is famous for its innovation. It's able to do things, to risk things that governments often don't want to do. And this NGO, the International Rescue Committee, has nobility of purpose, but real bravery in delivery. And I wanted to associate myself with that and then try and write the next chapter in this illustrious history of this organization.
And you assume you could leave Britain to go do this and then you could go back when you decided to re-enter politics.
You can't assume anything. And in our system, it's harder to go in and out anyway. But so, I mean, one of the things you learn in life is that you write one chapter at a time. Mm. And I'm very committed to this organization. I've been there for 3 months now. We've moved the family to New York. That's not the sort of thing you do just to change your mind in 5 minutes. And so my focus is really, how do we take this humanitarian agenda to the next level at a time when many people in our countries want to think about
the home
front.
This is a very tough job, and that's why. I mean, you take it because of the challenge. What else did you consider doing?
I looked for an opportunity to really make a difference around the world. I thought it would be very hard to get to do something in Britain because people would be saying, well, look, why aren't you in politics?
Right.
And so it was right. I'd spent 3 years as foreign minister. I wanted to give vent to the internationalism that I had. And there's another thing which is important. My parents were refugees.
Yeah.
So I'm the first generation in my family to be born in Britain. My dad came to Britain in 1940. My mum came to Britain in 1946. My dad from Belgium, my mum from Poland. They lost many, many relatives in the Second World War. And so I felt in some way I was closing a personal circle by repaying a bit of the debt that I owe to the people who helped my parents by helping their successors today.
Join us online at charlierose.com.